She will sketch out her vision, her ambitions, and I think we'll want to chart a different course to signal that she is distinct and different to David Cameron. Then, of course, she has to get down to the hard business of forming a new government. One thing we have been briefed overnight is to expect a significant increase in the number of women in the cabinet, including in the most senior post. So I would imagine we should expect to see a woman either as Chancellor or Foreign Secretary or Defence Secretary. And also, we're being told top priority has been given to appointing this new Brexit minister to handle our negotiations with Europe, and a search has already begun for a building to house the new Brexit department.
It's worth saying, isn't it, that when we talk of her choosing her new team, she doesn't even have a team of assistants ready to go into Downing Street, in the sense that, you know, a leader of the opposition has months, years maybe, to prepare. If she'd been running in the leadership contest, she would have had 9 weeks to prepare. She's had about a day and a half.
Everything has been extraordinarily accelerated by the aborted leadership contest, and that does put huge, huge pressure on Mrs. May to construct a new government. But the one plus, it seems to me, and it is a big plus by the fact there isn't this leadership contest.
This is working brilliantly.